So, welcome back. Now, what we'll do, we have created the drag and drop. So, what we'll do, we'll remove the names, whatever coming, like drop zones are coming, not names. So, we'll switch it off, okay, because it doesn't look nice. Okay. So, is this go to the my account again. You can see this created projects and you can modify that. It's taking time. Now, what I've created now, country and flag. You go here, there is edit button is there. You edit now and switch off the names of drop zone, okay, because it doesn't look nice. Okay. Now go to the task. The task click the drop zones. Go to the pencil. Pencil means edit. So what do you say? Show the level. You switch off the level. Switch off the You can go to the drop zone two. Go to the pencil means edit. Switch off the show level. Similarly, go to drop zone 3. You switch off the drop zone. You go to the fourth one. You can say, don't show the label. Now you can see it is very clear. Okay. I just go down and save. Not that a drop zone will not appear now. Just go again. Country and flag. You can see here the drop zone names are not coming. Nothing is coming. Only when you want to drop. Okay. Just make it a little bit smaller. Now suppose when I drop, it only shows the areas where I can drop this. Okay. So I drop here. And suppose I don't drop others, what will happen? How many marks you will get? Can anyone tell me? Only one marks you will get. Okay. The other answers he has not given. Only one. You can get a C here. This way you can create. One more assignment we'll take. That is, you can write a mathematical equation. And paste in the JPG and tell other to identify what is the type of that particular equation. Okay. Already I have sent you. So just create new content. Just press button, create new content. So we have to say drag and drop again. Click. So I have already sent the loss equation and loss. We just select the picture. You add the picture without the names, okay? If this is the one. This is one with the names of the laws. We have to select without law, without the names. वैसे होरिजेंटल स्पीकर, गो टू द टास्क नाउ। What we want is that height is it is little less. Okay, so what we'll make, go in setting. Instead of 310, I will make it 410. Okay. So the height will be comfortable. Now, now you create the drop zones. Then you create the names of the law, and then you tell what is the correct answer. Where you tell in the drop zone. Okay, while creating drop zone, you need not to mention anything. Okay, so create the drop zone. So drop zone one, opacity I will say 50%. Done. So once done, it somewhere it will appear. Okay, but now what you have to do is you have to adjust it to the size of the box. So I have not switched on the display of the name, so that's why the drop zone is not there. Okay. So what I'll do? I'll just click and say copy. Once I say copy, if I use Control V, so this is our drop zone. So I'll go to the pencil and say edit. I will name this as a drop zone 2. Okay. The disconnect is this. This is, I think, drop zone 3. Edit, go to edit button. I will say this is drop zone 3. Okay. So I'll again check drop zone 1, 2, 3. So we have created the drop zones, but right now we have switched off the zones. Okay. Now what I will do? Now we have to create the now names. Okay. Already given in the second figure the names. Puri years. Curious law of heat conduction. So I have to tell the software that students should able to drop this text in any field. Okay, students should able to drop this in the any field. Okay. So it has created now. What we have to do, we have to make it at the bottom, okay, so that we can drop like this. Now create second one. This is a Fourier's law of heat conduction. Next is this law is what? Newton's law of cooling. Newton's law of cooling. So I tell the software that student should able to drop in all the zones. So opacity I will take 50%. Done. So first opacity I have to take it as 50%. So this is the Newton's law of cooling. Now next is the Stefan-Boltzmann law. Stefan Boltzmann. I tell the software that the student should be able to drop in all the three zones. Again, I have to place it bottom. So I created now. Drops on the names, but now again I have to tell the software that what is the correct answer. Okay, what is the correct answer? So again, go to the drop zone. What is correct answer for this? This is the Fourier's law is correct answer. You go, click the pencil, Say correct is the Fourier's law. Second drop zone, you go and say edit by clicking the pencil. Correct answer is Newton's law of cooling. Go to third, edit by clicking the pencil. Correct answer is Stefan-Boltzmann law. Okay. So now you have created the enter the correct answers. Now you have to tell the passing criteria. 0 to 39. Tell the student to please repeat. Repeat. Above 40 to 100, say best luck. So we can also select various ranges. Okay. So I only selected two ranges. Now say save. Once I tell save, it will get published. Once I say save, it will get published. So I will say save. It is saved. Okay. You can see now governing equation, name of the law. Now I know that this is the Fourier's law, Newton's law of cooling. This is Stefan-Boltzmann law. If I check, with all everything is correct, I am 100% means what? It will say best luck. It is saying best luck. 3 out of 3 marks. Okay. Similarly, you create now. Okay. Similarly, you create. This way we can do this. Okay. Now you can try at your end and you submit your work by sending the link. Okay. Now we'll move to the next topic, that is the interactive video. We'll move to the next topic, that is the interactive video. So I will just play one example from this. So you can see one video. Okay. Now what happens if the student is watching this video? For him, it becomes monotonous. He will stop thinking. Okay. So, but if you ask questions in between, he will be alert and he will be involved in the activity. Okay. also because of this interactive things, the question will pop up, and also we'll able to see the correct answer. Okay, so I'll just play this video. What you can see is a Titanic movie video. The Titanic ship is started. Okay. Now, in such a video, we can see that there is a power plant is there for the ship, propelling the ship. For propelling the ship, there is a power plant. Then we can ask a student what type of power plant it is. Okay, so I have put one question inside this. Okay. So when it reaches there, it will pop up. Okay. The dot you can see here, when it comes here, the question will pop up. Okay. It is asking what is the type of power. Okay. The question is coming like this. Here I have put only one question, but we can put many questions. Okay. Once the student click this, the question appears. What is the type of power plant? If he selects a wrong power plant like this, this is steam power plant. If you select wrong, then if he checks, it gives wrong answer again. If he retries and say correct power plant and check is correct, then he can continue. Okay. Then remaining portion of video will play. Okay. So this way, the student can implement interactive video. I think the today time is about to expire now. This time is over now. Okay. So and attendance is also not good today. So we'll take this interactive video maybe tomorrow. Okay. So let's see whether I can show you one more example. This is one more video I want to share. Here I have put many questions, but taken from Shah Rukh Khan movie. Here he comes from USA as a scientist in the NASA, and he wants to establish a hydroelectric power plant. But his power plant is having some we can say incompleteness. So I made the question in between to make the student alert. Can you hear the sound of the movie? Can you hear the sound of the movie? Hello? Can you hear the sound of the movie? Hello?
No, sir. There is no audio.
Okay. So here, what is happening? He established one hydroelectric power plant, and it is having some drawbacks. Like now, the flow is not going.
So what?
Yeah, why the flow is not going? So what he will do now? He'll jump inside the we can say reservoir, And at the inlet of Penstock, you will find that there is some debris. Okay, but in conventional power plant, there is already a solution for this. Okay, is just now removing that. Okay, but for conventional power plant, what we do is we provide one structure called as trash, so that the debris will not go at the inlet of Penstock. Okay, so I have put one question now here. You can see here. Okay. Question now. So blockage of Penstock. The student clicks this. We'll see that how the blockage of penstock can be prevented. So I know that possible solution is what? Providing the trash rack. But what he did by jumping and rooming that. Okay. So students, suppose he gives this answer, what Shahrukh Khan did, and checks, then the answer is what? Wrong. What is the correct answer? In design, he should provide the trash rack. If I say check, is correct. Okay. Continue. Now it will move further. Now we can see now the turbine. So we'll go now. Water is now increased. Now next question I will ask, what is the type of the turbine? If he, the student is very good, he will understand. If it is open type of turbine, it is what? Impulse turbine. Now it is open type of turbine. Okay, you cannot see casing. Okay. So it is what? It is actually impulse turbine. So if a student gives wrong answer, then checks, then it is wrong. So what is correct answer? You have to just refresh. Correct answer is what? Impulse turbine. So they use the impulse turbine. Okay. Now a few more question. Now you can use the what device is used to measure the RPM. Now Shahrukh Khan has used the impulse turbine for possibly this is the what he has used is a low head water availability. He should use the reaction turbine. Okay. So at the end, I am asking, what are the suggestions? Okay. Can you hear the volume now? At the end, I am asking, could you hear now the sound of the movie? Hello? At the end, I am asking, what is the, at the end, I am asking, at the end, I am asking what design changes student can suggest. You can suggest use of the reaction turbine as well as use of trash rack, means all of above. Okay, so this is correct. So in this way, we can develop interactive video. Already I have shared the links and questions. We can create that. Okay. Tomorrow we'll take that. Tomorrow we'll take the interactive video. Now today's session is over now. Okay, thank you. If you have any questions, you can ask me. If you have any question, you can ask me. So you submit now two assignments, drag the word and drag and drop. Okay. So I will send you the link for feedback in the evening. We have to give feedback for day one and day two. Okay, thank you. If you have any question, I will stop for 1 minute, and otherwise I will end the session.